Hello everyone, I'm Tony Thiel. I run the Whitefriars International Student Program, and I'm here on behalf of my school, Whitefriars Catholic College for Boys, and today I'll present to you on Whitefriars. So we are a boys-only school. We have been founded in 1961, and we are the only Carmelite college in Australia. I will also explained, I'll also at the same time translate in Chinese. So, 我们学校是怀特福利，我是学校的国际部招生官，也是国际部招生主任，不好意思，国际部主任。我们怀特福利学院就是起源于1961年，然后我们至今就是在澳大利亚唯一的 Carmelite 学校，我们是一所男校。 So as you can see, I have also included our school motto, belong to a learning community that will believe in you and guide you to become the successful gentleman you are destined to be. 所以在这一页我也加了一下我们的校训，也就是要学生属于一个会学习的一个在学习这个自然环境，然后就是相信自己，然后学校也会引导你去成为一个可以。 就是很成功的一个优秀的生士，就是把你潜能释放出来，就是帮你尽可能的把潜能释放出来，就是我们学校的宗旨。然后就是我现在给你看一个短视频，就是学校介绍学校的短视频。Now I'll play for you a short introductory video for our school. Please watch. Thank you. The video, and I'll continue on with my presentation. So this is our school map, an aerial photo of our school. As you can see, it is relatively large. We are located 30 minutes from Melbourne CBD, and as you can tell, our physical environment is very unique. We are situated in beautiful natural bushland, a total of 19 hectares in total, and we are one of the largest Catholic colleges in Melbourne, or even so in Australia, and our campus provides the basis for very rich and extended learning. 所以这个这页就是我们学校的一个照片，就是学校整个学校就是介绍你给你整个学校的那个概括，你可以看得到就是学校其实处于一个大自然环境，然后离墨本市中心也就差不多半小时左右。 开车距离，就是我们环境非常独特，导致学校能提供给学生一个非常优秀的学习环境，而且还能提供给学生很多课间以外的所谓的学习空间，就比如说地理能去后边的小溪后边的丛林去实地考察实地学习，所以我觉得我们学校这个自然环境和课间环境和 现代设施的那个融合是非常独特非常优秀的一个情况啊。So at Whitefriars, we offer a secondary school education. We are only years 7 to 12. Which is built on the foundation of the Carmelite tradition, as we are the only Carmelite school in Australia. The boys at our school share in the charism of the Carmelite values of love, respect, tolerance, compassion, community, and service. And the college as a whole provides a very, very nurturing environment for the boys to learn and do their best, as we believe everyone can achieve their fullest potential. At our school, we have a total of 1,200 boys, and of which about 40 are international. We have had our international program for 21 years of our storied history. For the past, 21 years, it has always been a good amalgamation together. 所以啊，这就是我们学校的一个照片，就是这就是早上清晨，就是早上八点多左右啊，孩子们背着书包，穿着校服啊，踏入学校的一个场景。就是在我们学校，我们是一所中学，男子中学，所以我们只提供七年级到十二年级的教育，而且整个教育是环绕着我们Carmelite 的传统，因为我们是澳洲唯一一个 Carmelite 的中学。Carmelite 的性格就在于就树立于爱，就是互相尊重，礼让精神，为社会贡献，做点贡献，而且就是树立成一个非常优秀的绅士，学校从而也会提供给一个非常优秀的学习环境给学生，为了确保学生能尽可能最好最快达到他们应有的潜能，因为就是怎么说呢，就是每一个孩子都有自己的潜能，然后学校就是一个平台给孩子发挥自己的潜能。So at Whitefriars, we understand that relationships are the key to continued success.And all boys are part of a highly supportive community. So they develop a very good working relationship with their peers, with their teachers, with everyone in school, with everyone in the community. We are a very community-based school. So everyone is expected to help each other out. Everyone is expected to contribute equally or to the school and to ensure the continued success of the school. We have a vertical pastoral care structure, which is very special in that our pastoral care classes consist of boys from years 7 to 12. So every single class will have a few boys from each year level. So as a result, the seniors are able to help the juniors. And the juniors can learn from the seniors as time goes by, which we believe is of paramount importance to the education of our young men. All these qualities form the cornerstone of who we are as a school and what we do at Whitefriars College. 所以呢，这个我们学校最注重就是人与人之间的互动，人与人之间的那个关系，人与人之间的信任，人与人之间的信赖。就是我们是一个非常community 的学校。就怎么说，我们学校树立于人与人之间的关系，就是家长孩子，还有甚至爷爷奶奶。老师、校长，全部人，就学校，的每一个分子都会提供给学校自己独特的怎么说贡献，然后从而导致孩子们能最优秀的发展，能最优秀的成长，能最优秀的提高自己的学习能力，能从七年级慢慢树立成才，十二年级毕业时候就是希望孩子们都能一个一个成才。这也是我们学校最重要的那个观念之一，就是要每一个孩子能就是学到如何做人，如何树立一个终身学习的那个愿景啊。所以我们学校有一个就是班级，因为在澳大利亚通常每一个学校都有一个所谓的班级系统，也就是说比如说每一个学生可能其他学校就是一个年级，每个年级有可能三四个班，然后有一个老师来照顾。我们学校呢，唯一最大区别在于我们每一个班级，所谓的班主任的班级呢，就是班里会有七年级到十二年级的学生，就每一个年级的学生都会 在一个班级里面就导致高年级的学生能帮助低年级的学生，而低年级的学生也能从高年级的学生上学到一些东西，然后到时候能互相帮助互相学习，这也导致我们七年级学生不会陌生，不会觉得没有人照顾他们，然后就综上所述，就是这到最后他们会给予一个非常比较好也非常好的一个环境，互相学习互相帮助嘛。然后去年因为就是活到老学到老，怎么说呢，七年级肯定是能跟高年级的学生学习，因为他们第一天踏入学校什么都不知道嘛，然后慢慢学慢慢学，高年级也能从新生身上学东西，所以比如七八九十十一十二每一年级的学生，就是可能一个班级，比如说一个班级可能会有两三个七年级，两三个八年级，两三个九年级，两三个十一年级，两三个十二年级左右，然后打成一个班级，然后一个班主任会照顾他们。这就是我们这个学校的概况，就是因为就是学生的那个安危，学生的整个素质教育，学生的整个心理，学生的生活，学生的学习都是一个非常重要的一点。At our school, teachers are super important, of course. Our teachers know that a key role is to spark in each boy a lifelong zest for learning and a drive to achieve his personal best in all aspects of life. So our teachers are not in school just to teach content. Our teachers are in school to encourage students to push the boundaries of their potential, to push the capacity of their learning, to promote and encourage and accelerate student excellence, to develop the student's individual character, to promote and to assist in the student's well-being, because at the end of the day, we want every single student to be able to achieve the as best as he can. 所以在我们学校呢，我们老师打着一个非常关键的一个责任，因为我们老师不仅仅是在班里教课堂内容，更重要的是我们老师就是会属于一个教导一个素质性教育的一个重大工程，因为就是怎么说，就每一个比如一个学生进来一个班级，他们会就是那个老师的主要责任，除了教课堂内容以外，也就是需要把学生的潜能提高出来，提拔出来，尽可能把学生的潜能拉到最高，尽可能把学生的那个学习状况做得最好，就是最可能把学生推到往远处推，然后顺便也不是顺便，就是在教学习内容的同时教学生怎么做人，教学生做人道理，教学生怎么素质性上的点点滴滴，因为这我们觉得就是怎么说，就是在培养学生的价值观非常重要培养学生的价值观世界观都非常重要，所以我们学校就是老师主要责任除了教导课堂内容，也就是也需要培养学生的世界观价值观，还有尽可能把学生的那个潜能拉满。So the photo, as you can see, is one of our ex-student captains carrying a young boy from East Timor on his back, and they certainly look very happy. This is because social justice, service leadership, and community experiences are very integral to our boys' education. We want our boys to be empowered to become change agents in a college community and in a global context. So there are a lot of extension classes, there are a lot of excursions, there are a lot of outdoor education classes, there are a lot of overseas trips and immersions. For example, this trip to East Timor, we also have trips to Indonesia, Italy, China, trips to Europe for battlefields, trips to USA, trips to Nepal, a lot, and every single of all of these activities contribute to a student's well-being, a student's character development, and a student's overall growth development. 所以你可以看到在我们这个照片里，就是我们学校之前的一位学长，然后他背着一个冬季温的小孩子主要是因为我们学校就是非常提倡这种回馈社会的这个回馈社会给社会提供一点贡献的这个 这个价值观，因为就是我们觉得，就是学校就觉得这个就是会改变一个学生的对世界的观念，就是所以我们学校其实对，就是设立非常多的，比如说国外的活动，国外的旅行啊，国外的学习，的团啊，还有很多在学校以内的，比如说高级班啊，户外班、户外活动啊，出去游学、出去课外活动等等都有。比如说就比如每两年都会去一次中国，就带学生去一次意大利，带学生去一次印尼，带学生去一次欧洲，然后带学生去一次美国，带学生去尼泊尔，还有每年的冬季温的这个旅行啊，就是给冬季温当地做点贡献。就前几年我们学校就在冬季温建了一个学校，建了一些设备，就是给东帝汶的那些人民有点的生活带来一点小改变。就是我们学校就是从这个东西方面，就是想给学生一个终身学习，就是树立一个一个世界观，就是让学生知道除了学术方面学术层面的观点之外，还有很多就是层面的学习需要去办，需要去学到才能好，就是完成一个中学生的那个生涯。 So we also have a music. 这就是我们学校音乐啊，这是我们学校的台上表演。 Our theater studies, our painting, our art. We have a very strong art department. 这是我们学校的艺术啊课。我们学校就是比如说艺术方面啊、音乐方面、运动方面、体育方面啊都挺好，就是尽可能提供给学生各个他们兴趣方面、兴趣爱好方面的一些培训班啊，一些辅助都有。So, Whitefriars International Student Program, which is what we are all here for. We are built on providing international students from across the globe the best possible learning experience to enhance their learning capacity and extend student potential, underpinned by exceptional pastoral care and well-being support in a safe and nurturing environment. 所以，这我们就来到今天的重点，就是我们学校的国际部啊。我们学校国际部就是已经有就是有至少三四十个学生，然后就是树立就是为了学生世界各地的学生来提供给他们一个最优秀的学习环境，提高他们的学习潜能，提高他们的学习能力，就是然后就是尽可能把学生的那个学习拉到最高啊，就是把他们就是树立成才啊，就是在一个非常温暖、非常照顾他们的环境下慢慢从一个小孩子变成一个绅士，这是我们最重要的达到的目的。因为就是怎么说呢，很多国际孩子第一次来到澳大利亚上高中的时候、上初中的时候他们可能就是需要很多的关怀，需要很多的照顾啊。我们学校就是会提供这个环境，从而让他们能好好的成长，在学习中快乐的成长，快乐的学习，快乐的成长。So let's sit. So because to add on, because a lot of students come from overseas, the first few days, the first few weeks, the first few months, they may not feel at home, they may need additional help. And as a result, they need additional welfare support, which we, at our department, we will provide. Because at the end of the day, what we want to do is to provide the best possible, most nurturing environment so that we can support the curriculum development, while at the same time ensuring that they are meeting their student capacity, their student potential. So, international students at our school start with an on-campus orientation program. Then there's two ways. Either they enter mainstream classes straight away, or they enter something called the Bridging Intensive English Program, which is our version of a language class. For example, we don't require our students to go through an external language provider, because at our school we have our own language program, English language program, which is very unique in the sense that it not only develops the students' English capabilities, but we also have math classes, you also have sport classes as well at the same time. Assisting the student to integrate into the school setting, into Australian life. And after they pass and complete our bridging intensive English program, they will go into mainstream classes and join the rest of the school cohort. So international students in our school are provided with every opportunity to succeed academically whilst being supported with integration into the wider school community by a wellbeing program across all year levels. 所以呢，我们国际学生啊，来学我们学校的时候，有两个，就是他们首先会有一个不好意思，所以我们国际学生呢，来初次来学校就有他们会开始有那个一个 orientation program， 就是他们会我们学校会带他们适应一下环境，适应一下适应一下墨本，适应一下澳大利亚，适应一下学校，适应一下学习环境，适应一下学习的课表，学习一下学习上班上学放学的时间，因为就是。大家在讲上学跟放学的时间跟中国是 不一样，我跟世界各地跟香港是中国东南亚全完完全全的不一样啊。然后呢，之后他们有两个选择：第一，如果成绩够好，他们会直接进主课；如果第二，如果他们英文不够好，他们会先进我们的语言班啊。我们学校有自己的语言班，所以完全不需要一个学生在校外上语言班，因为我们学校有自己的语言班。在语言班里，其实不只是教语言，其实我们在学校的语言班里还也会提供什么数学课啊、体育啊、运动啊，然后还有个很多就是提高学生的学习方面的一些课程，所以不仅仅是语言班而已。So as one of the cornerstones of the Whitefriars International Student Program, the Bridging Intensive English Program is especially designed to meet the needs of our students as they commence their life and study in Australia and Whitefriars College.So a lot of our students spend at least one semester at school in the bridging program before they enter mainstream classes. 所以就如果刚刚所说的就是我们学校的语言班就是特别设定给孩子们最好的学习空间，就是首先提高他们的英文，其次就是帮他们能适应一下澳大利亚和墨尔本和在学校的生活。所以通常学生会在我们语言班待差不多半年再去主课啊，通常如果他们的英文成绩够好的话，就根本就不需要语言班。就是如果他们达到我们需要进主课的英文成绩的话，完全不需要语言班。So if the student applicant can meet the requirements to enter mainstream classes in terms of their English language schools, they do not need to study in the bridging program at all. All our students stay in homestay in college approved homestays. These are just a few of our school homestays. Most of them are in the immediate surrounding areas. There are a couple just across the school. So the students just wake up in the morning, two minutes walk, or some less than a minute where they just cross the school and enter the school gates. All our homestay families are carefully chosen and screened. And our colleges, the most important point for colleges, look for a happy and welcoming environment because we expect a lot from our parents. The parents are expected to treat all our international students as their own. And all homestay parents are expected to attend all college specific events and also parent-teacher interviews. We also do things like twice a year checks, welfare checks. We make sure that, you know, they meet stringent criteria. If not, we are very strict on our homestays because we want the students to feel safe and to feel well looked after. 所以呢，我们学校每一个国际生就是都是住在寄宿家庭，除非他们有一个家庭啊，除非他们有一个家人在这里肯照顾他们，不然都会住寄宿家庭。我们学校国际部的寄宿家庭通常都是在学校周边，有些甚至在学校门口对面，所以有些学生就是可能早上起床走1到2分钟的路就到学校了啊。这四个图片就是都是我们学校的寄宿家庭啊，所以有各种各样的寄宿家庭，但是最关键就是我们学校对寄宿家庭要求非常非常高，我们对寄宿家庭非常严格。首先就是每一个寄宿家庭我亲自都会去检验，就是会，而且每两年每年都会做两次的一个探访，就是确保孩子们就是得到最好的照顾。因为我们 我们最在意的就是学生要在一个非常好的一个学习与居住环境下能成为他们最好的能成为一个最好的学生，所以我们学校就是在找寄宿家庭的时候，就是肯定是去找一个开心很温暖的一个居住环境，不然我们不可能会允许那个寄宿家庭做我们的学校的一个所谓的寄宿。 然后我们的寄宿家庭的家长，我们也会要求他们每年的什么各个学校的活动都需要参加，家长会也必须陪同您的孩子来参加，到时候至少寄宿家，因为我们要求我们学校的寄宿家长，我们的国际生当成就差不多当成自己的孩子来看待，这样一来他们就是我们的国际学生会得到最好的照顾，最好的照料。 So how do you apply for the school? How do you apply to be to our school? So as you can see, there is a photo of an application form. So essentially, you have to complete and return this form to us through the agent, through any your chosen agent. Alongside this application form, you submit a copy of your passport, you submit school reports for the last 2 years, and any relevant co-curricular certificates and awards. For example, piano, music, mathematics awards, science awards, English awards, sporting excellence awards, whatever. At the same time, we need a copy of your English language abilities. So please submit a copy of your AEAS results. We do need to take that into consideration. Thereafter, all applications are assessed by myself. And usually we'll require interviews. If we require interviews, we will let the agent know and the agent will let you know. And we will arrange interviews, whether be it face-to-face, if I am overseas and in your home country, or interviews can be done via digital means, WeChat, Skype, Zoom, multiple ways. So we've done interviews in the past through WeChat video calls, through Skype video calls, and through Zoom video calls. And I've also interviewed students in their home country, so there are multiple ways of doing it. And at Whitefriars College, we don't charge any application fees, so that's our difference. So, 所以呢，我们学校如何申请？首先，你得填一个申请表，这个照片就是这个页上的照片，就是我们学校的申请表。然后其次，填好申请表，你得 交上来的时候，同时你得交上一个你护照的那个一个护照，就是把你的护照复印了，然后交上来。然后我们也需要看到你至少两年的学习报告，就是学校之前学校的成绩单，我们需要看到至少两年的成绩单。然后还有什么课外活动，各种兴趣爱好的各个奖状都可以发过来，比如音乐啊，比如运动啊，比如数学啊、科学啊，各种奖状都可以发过来，让我们参考一下。 总而言之，我们也需要看到一个英文孩子的英文成绩的一个报告，所以我们要求学生去考 AEAS， 然后把这个 AEAS 的成绩单也交上来，把这些东西交上来之后，我会亲自去评估这个申请，然后如果我们需要孩子通过一个面试的话，我们会去安排面试，会通常会跟中介 安排这个面试，有很多种面试。首先，比如说，如果我在您的国家，我们就可以面对面面试；不然的话，我们可以通过微信啊，通过 Skype 啊，通过 Zoom 啊，都可以，就各种方面各种，就是大家方便的话都可以，都有很多种方式可以来面试。然后最重要的是，我们学校没有任何的申请费，所以就是有点不一样，很多学校都会收这个费，我们是不收这个申请费的。 这是我们学校的费用，This is our school's 2020 guide to fees. School fees are $27,050 per year. Homestay fees are $16,500 a year. And our bond is $2,000, which you will get back at the end of year 12. Healthcare is $600 a year, approximately $550 to $600, depending on which year you come and how many you stay. We do not charge an application fee. We do not charge a guardianship fee. And we do not charge any placeholding fees. On top of this, on your child's first arrival, if he comes alone by plane into Australia, into Melbourne, the school will pick him up at the airport and take him to the homestay free of charge. Included in the school fees would be things like laptop, and a lot of other miscellaneous fees are all covered by this school fees. But of course, things like school uniform, books, textbooks, stationery, public transport, all this is excluded from the school fees. They are additional on top of these fees that you pay. So, 你看得到就是学校的学费一年就是26,750，寄宿费就是16,500，押金2,100，差不多5到600一年，就是看孩子是几年来哪年来，然后来多久，就是会有一点区别，反正每一个学生都需要医保才能在澳大利亚做国际学生。最重要就是我们学校不收申请费，没有监护人费用。 也没有一个就是保费的费用，就是有些学校可能会收，就说你申请我们通过了，给你一个offer，然后给offer下了，然后如果你要把这个位置留下来，你需要交个费用，这费用是退不会退的，就是这样子。我们学校是不收这些费用，因为我们学校就是为了教育孩子，然后再者呢，就是当然哦，不好意思，忘了说，当然这个费用。 就是这个学费当中包括了，包括了电脑，学生，因为我们每一个学生都会配一个笔记本电脑，然后这个电脑的费用是包括在这学费里的。当然，书本啊、文具啊、校服啊这些东西，当然就是另外算啊，因为就是学生得自己去掏腰包。可是我们还有一个特点，学校还有一个特点就是，如果您的孩子第一次来墨尔本来上学的话。 学校也会去机场接他，然后把他从机场接他了之后，把他送到寄宿家庭，然后安排好一切，就是这个点，就是这就是为了学生，就是给学生一个温暖，就是让学生知道，学校其实就是会全方面的照顾他。所以，so as a in summary, our school as a at our school, we are very unique. We provide a comprehensive international student program. We go above and beyond what the normal, a lot of normal programs. We do extra things like 24/7 support. We provide after school support. We provide additional classes. We provide extra in-class support. For example, if your child has difficulty in the classroom learning a certain subject, we can also provide an additional teacher sitting next to him to assist him in his learning. all our parents and students will have access to my personal numbers, and they are allowed to contact me at any time. I'm on pretty much 24 hours standby, and we try to form a very good working relationship with all parents and students, because we believe that is the way to deliver the best possible education, best possible character development for your son. 所以呢，就是我刚说的，就是我们学校国际部就是比较特别，就是比在于我们就是提供很多额外的东西，就是比如说我每一个学生、每一个孩子、每一个家长都会有我私人的。联系方式，然后随时都能联系上我，因为我们最重要就是要保护学生孩子的安危。我们需要知道孩子任何时间就是处于一个安全的状况，就是我们不想让孩子遇到什么麻烦，遇到什么不该发生的事情。然后如果学习还有就是如果学生学习上有任何问题的话，我们也会提供额外的帮助。比如说，如果学生在一个数学班里有。 或者在一个科学班里需要额外的帮助的话，我们可以安排一个老师，就是在他旁边帮他，就是讲解，就是额外的讲解他的需要做的事东西。然后学校，比如说还有什么放学后的自习啊，放学后的额外的辅导课啊，各种各类的东西。就是比如说，总而言之，学校就是要。 提供给学生最好的学习，以生活范围啊。 然后就是为了确保孩子们能有一个最好的方式来成长，有一个最好的方式来学习，有一个最好的方式来成为他们最好的自己，然后能上最好的大学。So that's about it. If you have any questions and if you need further information, please feel free to email me. My email number is there. My phone number is there. Please feel free to email or call. 所以这就是我今天想要说表达的。如果你有额外的问题，或者是有什么想需要我额外的讲解的话，您可以就是发个电邮给我，或者打个电话给我。我可以读得了中文，也看得了英文，所以我两个语言都可以，所以随便随时请可以发个邮件给我啊，谢谢。